Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. This is just a small continuation video of our past lecture only, guys. So in K-maps, we have discussed about how you can draw K-maps. We discussed about how you need to draw K-maps, how you are going to represent it, how many combinations you can make, like 2, 4, 8, 16. Okay, and we took an example with don't care. Right? Yes. So till here we have discussed, like, the video is around 27 minutes. If you haven't watched it, I request you to watch it, guys, because you will be getting a clear idea how to work with K-maps, guys. Okay, yes. So now you are clear with how to work and how to make combinations, right? Yes. So anyway, if you are still having some doubts, please solve some examples, and after that solve the PYQPs, guys. So anyway, in PYQPs series we will be going to solve each and every question, so you will not be having any doubts, guys. So watch this course lectures, then move on to PYQPs. Okay. Yes. Okay. So now we are clear with until here, right? Yes. So we took a small example and we have solved it with the don't care. Okay. Yes. So now coming to the basic terminology, I told you we will be discussing about some terminology in this lecture, right? Yes. So let us start. So the first terminology is implicants, guys. Okay. I'll be showing you the definitions, so don't worry. So the first thing is implicants. Okay. So what is implicant? Implicant is nothing but collection of adjacent minterms are called as implicants. Okay, so whatever you combine, okay, so this is an implicant, guys. This is an implicant. So this is an implicant. So you might be saying that, okay, so how I am saying those are implicants? So what is minterm, guys? So this is a particular minterm, right? So it is A, B bar, and CD. So that's a minterm. So this is an implicant. So this is an implicant. This is an implicant. This is an implicant. So that is nothing but implicant. So it is nothing but collection of adjacent minterms. Okay, so this is our first definition. The second one is prime implicants, guys. Remember, prime implicants. Okay, so if you observe here carefully, I'm writing this cell only clearly, guys. So it's a 4 cell, right? 7. Okay, so what's the below number? 6, 15 and 12. So here we are having D, here we are having 1, here we are having D, and here we are having 1. Okay, yes. So now what is a prime implicant, guys? Okay, so prime implicant is nothing but it is the maximum size possible, guys. Okay, so basically implicant can be single cell or 2 cells or 4 cells or 8 cells or 16 cells, guys. So it is not fixed to this cell only. It could be this 2 combination also. So this also, or it could be these 4 combination also, this also. Similarly, it could be this also. Okay. Yes. So there is no limitation in sizes. So it is not saying that the maximum one, it is not saying that the minimum one. So that is the concept of implicant. Coming to prime implicant, it is the maximum size, guys. So here you can take a 4 one, right? Yes. So here this one is a prime implicant. This is a prime implicant. Sorry, implicant. This solely is an implicant. This both 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 is an implicant. This solely is an implicant. This solely is also an implicant. But the prime implicant is nothing but the maximum one, guys. Okay, so now you are getting an idea, right? So what is an implicant and what is a prime implicant? Okay, yes. So now let us go to the definition. So implicant is called as prime implicant if it is not a subset of any other implicant. Got it? It is a maximum one, so there is no subset of this. So someone is not occupying this particular spot. So assume, so let us make it a bit big. So D1, D1, 1D, right? So this is the 8 cell, right? Okay, so if you observe carefully, these 4 can be combined as there are no things here. So this will be our prime implicant, guys. But if there are some things here, so at that time this will not be prime implicant because you are having an option to make 8 one, right? Yes. So that is the concept of implicant, prime implicant, guys. Got it? You are getting some idea, right? Yes. Okay. So now moving on to the last type, that is nothing but essential prime implicant, guys. Okay, so in some cases you will have some subsets which are redundant, guys. So let us take a small example. Okay, so let us take a simple example, guys. Okay, so A, B. So here we are having A bar, B bar, B. Okay, so if you take a small example in this way, so at some point this one could take this location. Sorry, I think this example will not work, guys. Okay, sorry for that. So let us take the bookish example only, in book which I wrote. Just give me a second. I'll be just drawing it. 1, 2, 3. A bar, B bar, A bar, B, A, B, A, B bar, C bar, C, A, B, C. Okay, yes. So let me draw the complete 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So here we are having a various variables, right? Yes. So if you start combining, some places you will get confused, guys. I'm clear with it, okay? Yes. So at some point, you are 100% sure that this should be taken, right? So for that reason, you will combine these two. That's absolutely correct. And for this reason, for this particular, there is no other combination. So you will combine these two. Okay. So what are these values? Let us write. So in this row, we are having C bar. And in this column, the common thing is A, right? So A C bar. Similarly, here C is there. And in these two, the common is A bar. So A bar C. Got it? Yes. Okay. So these two are compulsory. But when you take this one, so there are two options here. So the first option is you can combine these two, right? Or you can combine this way, like folding. So you can fold it and you can combine these two. So now you're confused, like which to take. So these two, which are mandatorily to take, are called as essential prime implicants, guys. So where you are having choice. So basically this blue one will be A B bar, right? And this brown one, okay, will be B bar and C. So in this two, B bar is common, and in the row we are having C. So among these two, you need to select one. So basically here we are having two essential prime implicants, and the total prime implicants are four, because here you are having 1, 2, 3, and 4. Got it? Yes. So this is the concept of implicants, prime implicants. So in some questions, he could ask how many expressions are also possible. So here we are having option, right? So you need to take these two mandatorily, but you can take this ones and this ones. So you are having total expressions are two. And how many literals are there? So literal is nothing but the count of these letters, guys. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay. So 6 literals are there. So in this way, these kind of questions could be asked, guys. Okay. Yes. So for our easy understanding, I have taken a previous year question in my book, guys. Okay. So anyway, I'll be just noting it down here so that we can solve it right now. It's GATE 2004 question. So he gave F of A, B, C is equals to A bar C plus A C bar plus B C. So the thing which he asked is to find the minimized expression, guys. Okay. So the first thing which you will be doing is you will be writing it in this way. A B C, A bar B, A B bar, C C C bar. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So whenever the question is given in terms of this expression, so he did not give any kind of numbers, right? So he gave expression. So A bar C. So first to find A bar, guys. So it is in these two rows, right? Yes. So keep your fingers there. And where C is there, it is there here, right? So write there only. Don't write here because it is C bar, right? Yes. So now you got an idea. Now try for A C bar. So find A, where it is there, it is in between these two, and C bar is here. So right here. Similarly, BC. So where B is there, here B is there in between these two, and where C is there, here it is there. So indirectly. Okay. So just give me a second. Sorry, my bad. So it is B bar C. So B bar is here and C is here. So it will be here. Okay. So now the question is, he is asking what are the essential prime implicants, guys. Okay, so my bad. This is the exact question which you have solved. So these two are the essential prime implicants. Okay, so let me write them down. So these two will be there and these two will be there. So this is a nothing but here what is common? A bar C. And what here is common? It is a nothing but A C bar. So these are the essential prime implicants. So in this way, you can get some simple questions, guys. Guys, the thing is, they will not take lots of time. The thing is, you should concentrate while doing, and you should not do any kind of silly mistakes. Okay. Yes. So this is one more example which I have solved. So I'll be just drawing the table so that we can just try it within a minute. Okay. Yes. So sigma m of 0, 1, 2, 8. 9, 12, 13. Guys, I request you to take a small piece of paper and solve it, guys, because it will be practice for you only, right? Yes, 15. 3. Okay, yes. So here I'll be taking A B C D. A B A B A B A B C D C D C D C D bar 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 done. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 13 14 15 okay so let me write down the numbers so 0 1 2 8 where is 8 8 9 12 13 right yes so we have returned these ones so now let us write these so it is at 10 11 14 and 15 so now if you concentrate carefully so here there are various things right okay so the first thing which you should notice is what are the things which we cannot take in any way guys so the first thing is this one is having multiple options but it is having only one maximum option so it could be mapped these two like two two so like corner ones right yes. But that's not the maximum one right so it could be mapped in this way right four corner piece if you recall okay so what is this brown value that is here in these two rows we are having a b bar and in these two columns or rows don't I am a bit confused guys so in these two columns we are having a b bar common and in these two rows we are having d bar common okay so now we are done with one thing right so now if you observe carefully so this value is having only one option with four right so let me take some other color so in this way that can take right yes so what is the value of that that is a nothing but so these two right so what is common there it is a b bar and what is common here it is c bar so b bar c bar will be there done so now moving on we are having these two left out so if you observe carefully you can take these four right so what is in this guys so it is a nothing but a right yes so is there anything common in these four rows no so a is the result here okay yes so the final expression is a plus b bar c bar plus b bar d bar so in this way using k maps when given the truth table or the SOP or POS you can directly convert into expression guys so this is the major advantage with k maps guys okay yes. So be perfect with k maps and you need to be clear with essential prime implicants and prime implicants guys okay yes so now I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this k maps concept okay yes so let us go through the final small concept guys that is a nothing but irredundancy function okay so not a minimal function and has no exact terms that can be removed is called as a irredundant function guys so most of you will not be getting a clear idea with respect to this thing but let us go through a small example okay so if you observe here carefully okay so here we are having x z bar plus y bar z plus y z plus x y okay so if you map this it will look in this way guys okay okay so if you map this you will it will look in this way okay but if you observe carefully you cannot minimize this particular expression here guys okay that is nothing but no exact terms or min terms and no minimal okay but if you draw the k map and if you want to minimize it you can get a minimal expression but this expression is absolutely correct there is nothing wrong in it like there are no extra terms which could be removed directly so those kind of functions are called as irredundant function so there is nothing to remove directly so here I cannot remove x z and it will be the same result there is nothing extra but it's showing exactly but there is some redundancy that is nothing but irredundant functions okay yes so I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this k maps and all those things so in the next lecture let us discuss about a NAND and OR implementation and we will learn why they are universal gates guys okay yes so I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this k maps right okay so don't worry much about k maps guys please solve some problems and anyway in PYQPs we'll be solving many examples okay yes so I hope everyone got a clear idea so in the next lecture let us continue with the next question next topic thank you thanks for watching like share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this thank you.